Jatha taralamulli sechanena tippantiskando hujo pusaka prano puharascha jatendriyanam tathaiva sarva arhananam achyatejya Yatha taralamulli sechanena tippantitaskando hujo pusaka prano puharascha jatendriyanam Tathaiva sar arhanam arhananam uchyate uchyatejya Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told to satisfy, to seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord and to seek the satisfaction of public is not the same. Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told to seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord and to seek the satisfaction of public is not the same. Those who are interested to seek the interest of public to get some name and fame and position, it is not possible for them to sing the glories of Supreme Lord. Not possible. Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, those who are 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, only and only they can speak about that absolute truth. Only and only they can speak about that absolute truth. It is not possible for others to speak about that absolute truth. Not possible. Srila Saraswati Thakur told, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving us everything. We have everything by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only we will have to follow him in toto. That's all. We are getting everything by the mercy of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only we will have to follow Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur in toto, very carefully. Guru Pad Padma Paramahansa Sister Srila Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, on all of our Guru Varga, most of them used to say, it is not possible for you to run Gauriya Math. It is not possible for you to run Gauriya Math if you want to ignore Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. If you like to run Gauriya Math, it's a one kind of false ego. Gauriya Math can run automatically. Gauriya Math is not a material place. Gauriya Math is Vrindavan. Gauriya Math can run automatically provided you are following Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Those who are speaking that it is not possible to run Gauriya Math if we follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada in toto, for them it is my request, they go back to home and lead their family life. It's good. Otherwise, they can observe the birth anniversary of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all drama, nothing else. You can see that Gauriya Math is running very fast. If you can follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, then you can see Gauriya Math automatically running. Otherwise, you can run a society. Not Gauriya Math. Otherwise you can run a society, not Gauriya Math. It's not possible. Anyway, I was discussing all about Dhuva Maharaj yesterday. How Dhuva Maharaj come out successful in bhajan. And Supreme Lord very interested to see his teeny devotee. Dhuva Maharaj. And I was speaking all in details about what Dhruva Maharaj is doing, everything. But when Dhruva Maharaj, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, because Supreme Lord promised, Supreme Lord, you know, bless Dhruva Maharaj, that you try to get control over this whole world, I mean, you know, try to rule the whole world, and at last moment, you can come to me, no problem. Because you are fearing that how I can run this, how I can rule this material world is not possible for me. It is a kind of bondage for me. Supreme Lord speaking, no, it's not bondage, I bless you. You can run this, you know, very safely, and at last moment I promise you, you can come to me. I give you the topmost place in cosmic system. You are giving the topmost place, that is Dhruva Lok, Dhruva Tara. One star is there, his name is Dhruva. You can get that place. Dhruva Lok. Dhruva Lok is topmost place. When, you know, Prakritic Polar take place, you know, that time also, you know, somehow it is protected. It's Vaikuntha actually. Almost. Now, after that, at last moment, Dhruva Maharaj wanted to make his son king, eldest son. Dhruva Maharaj wanted to make his eldest son Utkal, king. But Utkal is very less interested. I cannot. He is always thinking about that Brahman. He is less interested about this material world. At the same time, he was very clever. Yeah, he used to exhibit him as a crazy man. He used to play like, you know, Jadavaradji. He used to play like a crazy man. I'm crazy. So people say he's crazy, how to make him king? No. Better you see one thing, the next son, Batsa, we can make him king. The all ministers, they took decision together with Dhruva Maharaj. Batsa running, ruling this world very nicely. And now Dhruva Maharaj wanted to climb the eternal abode, you know, Dhruva Lok. So one day, at the last time actually, the plane coming, I mean Biman coming, very nice, you know, chariot. All, you know, Parshad of Vishnu, all four hands, nice. You are requested to come and get into this, you know, plane. Supreme Lord sending us. Well, he wanted to get into the plane, I mean the chariot. When one step given in plane, I mean chariot, one step is still there in Bhumi. Bhumi means this earth. Then one black man, very, very dangerous, like Rakshas, coming in front of Dhruva Maharaj. Hey! Where you are going? Dhruva Maharaj first asking, who are you? Who are you? My name is Mithu. Death. Mithu? Okay, nice. Then Dhruva Maharaj keeping one leg on his head and climb the plane, ignoring him. Go. Useless. Because, what does it mean? There is no solution of death in this. Be careful. There is no solution of your death in this material world. Nothing. So you must act accordingly. If you remember all the time, any time I am going to die, any time, any fraction of moment, then no kind of enjoyment, this mood cannot touch you. It's a very vital point. All the time, every fraction of second. You must remember, any time I am going to die. I cannot pick up enmity with you, though you are treating me very badly, though you are misbehaving me, still I think I have no enmity with you. Because I know, directly or indirectly, everything done by the Supreme Lord to test me, and then Krishna Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, can accept me. Without any testing, Supreme Lord cannot take you. Maybe you have come good family, high family, maybe you have big affluences, maybe you are very, beautiful, maybe you have very strength, manpower, money power, but Supreme Lord less interested about it. Nothing is permanent, all temporary. All your bank balance, all your body, all your material education, all your beauty, everything. Today is there, and tomorrow going to change. So be careful. But Dhruva Maharaj, the case is totally different for Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj is smart enough to ignore death. Who are you? He put one death on his head and climbed the chariot. To prove in this human society, if you are going to do Krishna bhajan, nobody can do any harm to you. There is no power in this world can stop you. But there should be that kind of tenacity in you. So after that, Dhruva Maharaj asking, looking around, where is my mother? Those, Parshad, they could realize whom you are searching for. Mother? Oh, mother already there, in the first plane, already going. So Suniti and Dhruva all successful. By the mercy of Supreme Lord, they are successful, their bhajan is successful. They are giving an excellent example, putting an excellent milestone, an example in front of us. That is why, see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Paratpara Kileshwar, Supreme Lord, Supreme Godhead, in his Nilachal Khetro Leela, he always used to request to Gadadhar Pandit, Gadadhar, I like to hear about Dhruva Charitra. Prabhu, I already read it 2 months ago. No, again. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to speak this way. I like to hear about Dhruva Maharaj. I like to hear about that. You can read about Prahlad Charitra. I like to hear. People, those who are foolish, they cannot understand the meaning. Why Mahaprabhu is speaking this way? Why Paratpara Kaleshwar, each and every action of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is an illustration for us. Is an example, vivid example. Be careful. If you want to become a Vaishnava, Vaishnavi, you must follow Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in toto. Don't try to break anything whimsically. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove this evidence, prove this in thing, that you should follow all, in Bhagavatam, all your Prahlad Charito, Dhruva Charito, everything is very important. Step by step, you must go up. First up to 9th canto, you can find all about this Bhagavat. What? Bhakti Bhagavat. Gradually, the king and this, that, those devotees, gradual promotion, and avatar also. I can discuss this point at the end of 9th canto. It's very important. And after that, you see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove it's all important. You will have to maintain your slow and steady improvement. If you like to jump up to 10th canto, you can fall down and break your leg and head, everything. You can die forever, spiritual death. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never give you, this kind of, lesson Then you must jump. Otherwise, what use? After 9th can you can throw? No. So, Dhruva Maharaj actually very important. After that, we find in the, you know, the first son of Dhruva Maharaj ignored. He is the, his name is Utkal. He is less interested about this material, you know, world. He wanted to prove that I am a crazy man. So naturally, the second son Batsa, those minister, and Dhruva Maharaj also took decision to make him king, to maintain this, you know. So it was done. And in their destiny, gradually, in the way, finally we find Anga Maharaj. He was very pious man. But he got one son in his life who is very dangerous, notorious. So he was feeling very, very sorry he was feeling. Repeatedly speaking, but he is not over. He is not at all ready to obey. Finally, Anga Maharaj took decision to go to forest and do the bhajan of Supreme Lord. He did it accordingly. And after that, Ben, the notorious son, those ministers took decision, they took decision to make him king. But finally, it was very dangerous. The consequent, the result was very bad because they are, you know, very bad situation created by them. Then all those, you know, Rishi Manis, they took decision to approach him very politely and request him to change his attitude so that the whole system can be, you know, okay. But he is not ready. He is not at all ready to obey. Hey, you are speaking wrong. Whom you are worshipping? Who is Supreme Lord? I am king. It is your duty to worship me, king. It is written there in Shastra. Then those Rishi Muni, they become very angry. Curse him. Duh! Curse him. Then Ben was burned to death. After that, I already told how Prithu Maharaj came here, Orchi and Prithu Maharaj. Now, after long discussion, we are coming to this point that Prithu Maharaj actually ruling this, you know, earth, world, but somehow there was feminine. How? By actually, Prithu Maharaj took decision to give punishment to Prithivi Mata. He is Vishnu. Prithu Maharaj is, you know, avatar, not ordinary man. Then Prithivi Devi very fearing, I am ladies actually, and why you are talking, Mataji, you should not attack me, but why you are not giving? All seeds and grain, everything, all my prajado subjects, they are suffering too much. Okay, you arrange the situation in such a way, so that I can be saved. Why? But those who are liars, those who are not following dharma, they are all enjoying, they like to enjoy me, my body. So I am feeling very, you know, bad. I am crying all day and night. If you can change the situation, okay. I am going to give everything though. Don't become angry with me, don't kill me. Then Prithivi Mata requesting Prithu Maharaj, doing some stotra. Prithu Maharaj bless, okay, no problem. After that, Prithivi Mata speaking, that in the form of Gomata, Dhenu, I can stand in front of you, you can milk, you can get out everything. Everything. You can get everything according to your pot. If the pot is tiger and lion, you can get blood and flesh. If the pot is in Rishi Muni, you can get, you know, all Vedanta, everything. This way, according to pot, you can collect everything. This way, Prithu Maharaj arranged everything and the situation come to normal. Now after that, Prithu Maharaj wanted to do 100 Ashwamedh Yajna and started Yajna. Who can stop him? He is all powerful. Nobody can stop. Up to 99 Yajna he was complete, successful. After that, Indra was very fearful. Maybe he is going to take my post. I am going to lose my position and rank. So I can stop him doing number 100th Yajna. I cannot allow him to do. So each and every time when the Yajna going on, sometime he is stealing Yajna, sometime making this problem, that problem. Prithu Maharaj feeling disturbance. Hey, who is doing this disturbance? Those rishis, those Ritik, you know, those who are doing Yajna, Hota, Udgata, Ritik, they are there. Very different kind of system there in Yajna. Those are only reading Veda Stotra, there's Hayam, Vedic Hayam. Those who are offering, you know, sacrifice, you know, those who are looking for the any defects there happening or not. So many systems, you don't know. Dhumaraj, who is making disturbance? Those Rishi Muni say, actually, Indra, the king of some, making disturbance. Why not you arrest him, being here? Okay. Then they do Yajna, Om Swaha, and Indra coming to fall down on Yajna. Then Brahma coming, what you are doing? Why he is making disturbance? No, you have no right to kill. You have no right, has some system in this, you know, cosmic world. Maybe you are king, but you have no right. Indra cannot be killed by you. It's not good. Prithu, don't do it, Maharaj. After that, somehow by the request of, you know, Brahma, he was bound to, you know, shave him. But after that, you know, you see, Otrimuni was there before this, you know, understanding. Otrimuni speaking, Indra stealing this Yajna Gona, I mean, this horse. Indra, Otrimuni says, that the Indra going. Hey, catch, arrest him. The son of Prithu Maharaj, it's very nice, you see. He is a Vijitasya. He is so powerful. He is running to chase him. Indra become very fearful. Leave the horse and go away. Fly. Another time, this, you know, Vijitasya means who was successful to get the horse back. It's called Vijitasya, his name. Very scientific name. After that, someday, again Indra making disturbance in the, you know, dress of Pasanda. Pasanda, you know? Pasanda, the very... Pasanda, this word, Viswanath Chakravarti was explaining. Those who are having some faith, preliminary first. After that, they are committing apradh and losing everything and become demon. They are actually Pakhandi. Then, Vijitasya following, hey, chasing. The Indra flying and taking the base of Pakhanda so that Vijitasya cannot identify me as Indra. He is in the guise of Pasanda. This way, each and every time Indra making problem, but still, Prithu Maharaj is so firm, determined, you see. He is the avatar of Supreme Lord, you see. Who can stop him? The position of Prithu Maharaj is, more and more high than Indra. Who is Indra? After that, you see, that when Brahma came, and after that requesting to Prithu Maharaj, oh Maharaj, though you are ruling whole world, you are king, but still it is not right, it is not good that you are going to kill Indra. But what to do? But no. better you can do one yoga less, 99 yoga is okay. Because yoga, what yoga can go for? What benefit you can get out of yajna? You are already getting Krishna bhakti. Indra not enjoying that kind of facility. You are full of bhakti. So maybe your 99 yoga, okay, leave it. Try to have an understanding with Indra, it is good. Then Indra coming with appealing mood. Oh Rajan, I have made a mistake. Okay, they make friendship. After the Indra giving a nice, you know, secrecy. This is a secret vidya. Is antodhan vidya. How to? I am sitting here, you cannot see me, vanish. Is antodhan vidya. So his name was actually Antadhyan. Prithu Maharaj is a song. After that, you see, his name was Antardhyan. He make a friendship with Indra. And finally, he complete yajna, 99. It's okay. One yoga less than Indra. Maybe Indra can see in topmost. His name is Satakrutu. We are not going to break this position and rank. Okay, it's less interested. Because Prithu Maharaj is less interested in name and pain. What? So 99 yoga, okay. After that, in this yajna, when the final sacrifice was being done there, then Vishnu Bhagavan came in four hands, nice, blessing, in front of Prithu Maharaj. Prithu Maharaj cannot speak, his throat, voice choked up, tears coming all the time, he cannot see, out of love, you know, ecstatic feeling. You know, then Supreme Lord, you know, coming in front of, you know, Prithu Maharaj and blessing him very nicely. After that, Vishnu Bhagavan going to give some instruction to Prithu Maharaj. Ho Rajan. Because actually, Yajna Purush, who is Yajna Purush? Vishnu is Yajna Purush. He is himself satisfied. So argument is that, when Yajna Purush himself satisfied with you, what more benefit you like to get? Tasmin tushte jagat tushto, prinite prinitam jagat. If Supreme Lord is satisfied with me, nobody is there to disturb me. You know, the sloka I started with, I can explain the sloka. If we put water in the root of one tree, then a whole tree can get nourishment. Bhagavan started speaking. First of all, Maitreya Muni is speaking. Bhagavan opi vaikunta sakam agavata vibhu. Yajgair yajyapati tushto ho yajyabhugatam avhasata tam avhasata. With Indra, swakam, maghavata. Maghavata is the name of, Bhagavan is name of Indra. Indra is so kind of satakrutu, Indra, Bhagavan, so many names. So here, swakam, Vaikunthapati, Shakshat Vishnu, coming together with Indra. Then Bhagavan speaking, actually, Maitraman speaking, when Yajna Purush himself satisfied, what deficit is there? Everything completed? All our bhajan, everything, all action is to satisfy Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. Be careful. Always try to remember this point. We want to satisfy Supreme Lord, Nityananda, Gaur Hari, and all Guru Varga, Radharani and Krishna. Is our ultimate goal. If you can fix up your goal, then you are not going to feel disturbance in your life. Be careful. So now Bhagavan speaking, Esho te akarishit bhangyam hayamedo satasya Eshoti akarishit bhangyam hayamed satasya ha. Is Indra. He is breaking your system. You wanted to complete 100 yajna. Is Indra coming with me? With appling mood. You know. Eshoti akarishit bhangyam hayamed satasya ha. Khamapayato atmanam amusya khantum arahasi. You must excuse him. Oh Prithu, you must excuse Indra. He is coming with appling mood. Those who are sadhu, what is the beauty with them? They are appling. They are actually forgivefulness. A sadhu can forgive 100 times. You have done, please excuse me. Okay. 100 times. Because no bonded soul, and anyway, bonded soul going to make mistake. Ah. Bonded soul anyway going to mistake. Srila Bhakti Bhaiva Puri Goswami Maharaj. One day, arrest one thief. He coming and stealing something. Somehow, somebody arrest him. Hey, come. They wanted to beat. Information came to Maharaj. Maharaj, where is that thief? Bring to him. Bring in front of me. The U.S. brought in front of Gurudev. He is crying. Hey, why you are stealing? What problem with you? He is crying. I have no money. I am very poor. If I can give money and set you CG, then you are going to steal anymore? No, no. Then I arrange you staying in what? You can stay and become sadhu. Yes. And from then he becomes sadhu. I don't want to give the name. It's not good. He become very good sadhu. This way sadhu is excellent, you see. You are so fallen soul, but sadhu can protect you anyhow. It's so powerful. Brahmando tarita sakti dara jane jane. You see. This way, you see, now Bhagavan, Supreme Lord speaking into Allah Dhu Maharaj, Eshoti akarashit bhangyam. Eshoti akarashit bhangyam hayame dasatasya. Kamapayotu atmanam amushakantumar hasi. He is coming with appealing muri, must excuse him. Purusha jadi mayanti tadrisha deva mayaya. Srama eva param yato. Dirgaya Vridya Sevaya. A super personality like you, hey Prithu Maharaj, you are a super personality. Great devotee. You are serving all Sadhuguru Vaishnava, also doing Jagya, having some love for me. If you are hypnotized by Maya, then what to speak more? If you are hypnotized by my Maya, the one what to speak more? What it concern to you? Maybe there's 99 yoga. Eh? Why you want to complete 100 yoga? I'm satisfied with you. Purusha jodi mohyanti tadrusha deva maya ya deva maya mane my maya. If maya going to touch you, then what I can speak more? Is one kind of maya you want to complete 100 yoga? I am satisfied with Yajna Purush. Purusha jadi mayhanti tadrisha deva mayaya sramo eva param yato dirghaya vriddha sevaya. Then all energy and money, everything used, all in vain, useless. So you stop and excuse, make a friendship with Indra. Then after that, make a friendship with Indra. And he is shown actually. His son actually got antadhyan vidya, how to vanish in front of you, vanish. It's very, very beneficial, can get extra benefit when you are going to fight with somebody. Like Indrajit, the son of Ravan, used to have that kind of capacity. He is fighting here, fighting. Where? He's where? You cannot find. Vanish. Indrajit. Yeah, so powerful. This way actually, Now, Maitri Maharaj, you know, Prithu Maharaj, I am Maitriya Muni speaking. Now, Prithu, by the advice of Supreme Lord, by the advice of Supreme Lord, instruction, this Prithu Maharaj is feeling, oh, so it's heart-touching, a feeling very heavy heart. And after that, you know, with a nice feeling and shedding tears. So, Maitriji Vacha, Prasthanabhi Mukho Opi Enam Anugraha Vilambitaha Pashyano Padda Palasaksho Na Prataste Shruhit Satam. Prasthanabhi Mukham means Prasthanabhimukam, when Supreme Lord when Supreme Lord going to leave this place. Climb is eternal abode again. Then Supreme Lord also cannot go. So loveful relation with Prithu. Prithu looking at Supreme Lord with heavy heart, they are going to leave me. I cannot feel that, I cannot bear that kind of separation. Prasthanabhi mukho opi enam anugraha vilambitaha pashyano paddo palashaksho na prataste suit satam. Bhagavan want to climb his eternal abode, but still his mercy was so strong for Prithu Maharaj. Supreme Lord want to leave, but cannot leave. Still more standing. So couldn't go quickly. He is lingering, making late. Like we are saying, a train is delayed by 1 hour. Supreme Lord, his plane is delayed now. You see. So only looking at Prithu Maharaj also looking at Supreme Lord, as Supreme Lord looking at him very, very sympathetically. Aso Adi Rajo Rochitan Jalir Harim Bilakitum Nasakanad Astrulochanaha Na Kinchan Uvacho Sa Baspo Biklabo Ar Hridopo Gujam Gujam Hidopo Gujam. Bolchen Upo Dhavad Avasthita. Some printing mistake here, maybe. Actually, saw Adiraj means Prithu Maharaj, folded hand, looking at Supreme Lord, shedding tears, cannot see properly, and voice choked up, wanted to speak something, as if he wanted to get the picture, not picture actually, Supreme Lord inside heart, want to embrace, is not going to leave him at all. Hridupu Gujyam. Omu. Some printing mistake can be. Anyway, after that, Prithu Maharaj started doing prayer in front of Supreme Lord. Oh Prabhu, you want to give me benediction. You are asking me, I like to bless you. Try to ask. What you want? I like to fulfill your heart. Now, Prithu Maharaj Vacho, Barana Bivo Tadbaradeshad Budho Katham Brinute Brinute Guno Vikriyatmana Jenarakanam Upisanti Dehinam Tadrisho Koivalapate Brinenacha Barana Bivo Tad Baradeshwarad Buddha Katham Brinite Guno Vikriyatmanam Je Narakanam Upi Santi Dehinam Tadrisho Koivalapate Brinenacha. I don't want to get that kind of advantage from you, benediction, what all you can get in hell also. You can go to hell? And there you can find all Jivatma bondage, so they are enjoying. In hotel you can show, they are dancing, taking wine, is one. It's hell actually, hell. In hell also, enjoyment there. Oh Prabhu, I don't want to get that kind of enjoyment from you. In hell also, different kind of material enjoyment available. So I don't ever expect that kind of thing from you. Baranabivo tadvaradeshva varadeshvarad buddhah katham vinite guno vikriyatmanam je narakanam api shanti dehinam tadrisho kaivallapate vinena cha. 23rd chapter. No kamaye naad tadapi aham kachit na jatra yusmad charanambujasabaha mahatma antar hidayad mukhachuto vidatsa karno karna yuta misho mevaraha no kamaye naad tadapi aham kachit na jatra yusmad charanambujasabaha mahatma antar hidayad mukhachuto vidatsa karna yutameshame varaha. I am going to get blessing from you, Prabhu, so that I can get billions of years. Billions of years, yes. This two years I have, one right and left. 2 years. I want to get billions of years to drink the nectarian harikasa from those great sadhus. Those are big, big sadhu, paramahansa. I like to get nectarian harikatha, I like to drink. But this two glass, this ear is like glass. I can prove this. In Dasam 10th canto, Benugita, I can prove those cows, they are drinking the nectar of fruit. And they are, this ear, cow gomata, you know, when you make the ear, this is like pot. All, you know, nectarian harikatha coming, they are drinking. It's like glass. So now, you must remember this, very important slope. Pithumar is requesting, Prabhu, I don't want any kind of benediction. What I can do with you? Oh, material benefit. Better you can give me, if you want to give me benediction, I like to get, you know, billions of, you know, years. So that all Harikatha coming out, flowing out from the lotus mouth of those pure devotees, Paramahansa, it is not sufficient that I can have only two glass. I need many glass. No kamaye na tadapi aham kachit na jatra yusmat charanam bujasabaha mahatamantu hrudayat mukachyuto vidatsa karna yutami shumivara. I want that kind of a... Could you grant? Yes. Sa uttama sloko mahat mukhachyato bhavad padam bojo sudha kananilaha svritim punar vismita tattva vatmanam ku yogi namno vitarati alambari. Alambari in Sanskrit word. Alambari mean... What I can do with bar? Stop. I don't need bar. Alambari. I don't need bar. Alambari. What I can do? Whereas your harikatha, your topics, harikatha, shottamo sloko, now uttamo sloko. I can discuss this point in 10 kanto also. What do you mean by uttamo sloko? If I ask you, what is the meaning of uttam sloko, this word? What do you mean by uttam slok? Uttam slok mean those sadhus, those paramahansa, they are speaking all your harikatha by sloka. You are uttama. Actually, the meaning is udgato tamo yasmat iti uttamah. Udgato tamo yasmat iti uttamah. Udgato jatmane, there is no rajatama gun, no sattik gun at all, only pure sattik. Udgato tamo yasmat iti uttamaha. And uttama sloka mean those manirishis, those sadhus, speaking out the glories, your glories through sloka. So they are all speaking about you, Uttamo. So you are Uttama Sloka. So Uttamoi Slokate iti Uttama Sloka. Uttamoi. Those who are Sadhuguru, they are speaking about you, they are Uttama Sloka. Uttamo Uttamo Slokoir. You know, Kathate iti Uttama Sloka. So, now, sa uttama sloko mahat mukhachyuto. Sa uttama slok, sa uttama sloko mahat mukhachyuto. Bhavad padam bujo sudha kana nilaha. Sritim punor vismrita tatma vatmanam. Kuyoginam no vitanati alam barai. What I can do with your benediction, Prabhu? Whereas we know, when those who are following unusual tack, those who are running oppositely in bhajan, they are not doing bhajan properly. So that is called kujoginam. Kujogi mane? They are not doing bhajan properly under the guidance of pure devotees. They are kujogi. Kujogi mean? Ku mean bad. Yogi mean they are doing bhajan. Yogi mean? They are trying to get in contact with Shiva somehow. But their procedure is not approved. It's bad. Not perfect. That's why it's called Kuyogi. Those who are not following their pure Guru Vaishnava properly. Even for them it is very good. If they hear all the topics of Harikatha, I mean Nectarian Harikatha, from the lotus mouth of pure devotees who have their influence of their efficacy, Vaishnava. Vaishnava is powerful. Why? Why Vaishnava powerful? Because they are acting according to their speech. Why they are powerful? What they are speaking, they are doing. Acharan. That's why they are powerful. You know, now if some kuyogi is there, at least he is not doing any aparad. A kuyogi, okay. He cannot understand bhajan. Those who are having this chance to hear Harikatha from the lotus mouth of Supreme Lord, I mean Guru Vaishnava, pure Paramahansa, they can also get the chance to change their life. Like Sukhdev Goswami, doing bhajan of Brahman, Parinischito Yopi Brahmi. Parinishchito opi Brahmi. Parinishchito mane? You are having so attraction from Brahma. Harer gunakhipta matihi. Harer gunakhipta matihi. Hare means Hari. So somehow he feel attraction out of Harikatha. Then he was not ready to do, previous bhajan. So it's kujogi. I give you example. Sukadev Goswami is interested to concentrate on impersonal Brahman. After that, hearing Harikatha, leave everything, feeling strong attraction for Krishna. Sa uttama sloko mahad mukhachyato bhavad padam bhuja sudha kana nilaha sritim punor vismrito tatmo vatmanam kuyoginam no vitaroti alambarai. What I can do with benediction, whereas out of your Harikatha I can get so much benefit. I'm very, very satisfied. Then Prithu Maharaj giving advice to his all, the inhabitants, subject, praja. Those who are living in his, country, Prithu Maharaj giving nice advice. The gist of that advice is that you must do bhajan perfectly, you must follow Supreme Lord in toto, you must give honor to Guru Vaishnava, you can lead your daily life in a very pious way. This is the actual advice. Without Hari Bhajan, you should not live, you have no right. This way, Prithu Maharaj is giving nice advice in front of those. Because Hari Bhajan is so powerful, that you can burn up all the, all papa, sinful activity, the result is there, you can burn up. Infinite, for infinity period, you are doing all mistake, doing pap. What do you mean by pap? And what do you mean by aparat? What do you mean by pap? Can you give explanation? You know? Pap is related to your material body and mind and fine body, subtle body. But aparad is, very dangerous. Aparad is very dangerous. Very dangerous. So aparad means you are going to some mistake, offense unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, Dham, Nam, anything related to Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan is called, if you are committing any mistake, is called aparad. This way. Very good, nice. Actually, Prithu Maharaj giving nice advice to them to lead their life a very nice way. After that, he is speaking, Namo Vishuddha Satyayo Purushaya Mahiyase Yo Brahmo Khatram Avishyo Vivartidam Sateyasa. And that Supreme Lord, Jini Brahman, the Supreme Lord actually giving influence inside Brahman, so they are going to regulate the whole, because as per, Varnasam Dharma, Varnanam Brahmano Guru, it is written, Varnanam Brahmano Guru, there are four Varna, four Varna, who? Shudra, Brahman, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. But out of these four Varna, Brahman is Guru. Provided one condition. Provided they are going to do bhajan. Brahmani vicharate iti Brahman. Brahman means Brahma. Brahman, why? He is in touch with as Supreme Lord, then he is Brahman. Otherwise not. We can find this sloka in 7th canto. Vipraddisaragunajutat-arabhindanabho padarabhindabhimukhad-sapacham-varishtham. We can show this sloka in 7th canto. Vipram-disaragunajutat-arabhindanabho-padarabhindabhimukhad-sapacham-varishtham. So here, Prithu Maharaj being Dandavat, their Supreme Lord coming inside, giving influence inside Brahman, so they are acting as Brahman. When they are giving power inside Kshatriya, they are also acting as Kshatriya. This way, Supreme Lord is all, So Kshatriya, actually, it is by the power of Vishnu. Why king is powerful? King is Vishnu Angsha. Vishnu giving power, transferring Teja inside Kshatriya. So they are ruling. That's why they are ruling. Namo Vishuddha Sattayo Purushaya Mahiyase Yo Brahmo Khatram Avishyo Bihorti Idam Sa Teyasa. Brahman ruling by his instruction, Kshatriya ruling by his power. Brahman ruling actually by Shastra, by quoting Shastra actually. And the Kshatriya, they are going to protect Brahman, give protection to whole society. They are going to protect the whole human society. They should be pious, they should protect Brahman, Go Brahman Hitai, Brahman, Gomata, they should protect. Actually, Prithu Maharaj, here you see, Prithu Maharaj now, he is full of love. He watching Sanatkumar, Sanandun, Samatkumar, they are all Chatushan coming. Like sun god, very powerful. Prithu Maharaj is there watching. What is that? Prithu Maharaj watching, what is that? Oh, big power coming out. Like sun god? After the, oh, it's not actually light. It's actually Chatushan. Chatushan coming actually, you see. So, Prithu Maharaj, you see, very, very happy. Aho, acharitam king me mangalam mangalayana. Yasvabho darshanam hi asid duddarshananancha yogi vi. Prithu Maharaj is, you know, with out of his love, shouting. Aho, bhajan, aho, acharitam king me mangalam mangalayana. What kind of good, auspicious activities they have done in past? So that I have chance to see that, you know, Chatushan is rare darshan. Even big, big personality, they are doing bhajan, they cannot take darshan of that Chatushan. Whereas I am so lucky. Eh? What I have done, I don't know. Aho acharitam king me mangalam mangalayana yasubo darshanam hi asit durdarsananancha yogi bhi. Those who are big, big yogi, they also cannot take darshan. Ah, now you are all coming in front of me. Then, actually, Prithu Maharaj folded and paid Brandabhat prostrated. After that, paying Swagatam bodhijo sreshtra yadbatani mukshava charanti saddhaya dhira bala eva brihanti vai. But actually, Dijo Srishto, because those who are realized soul, if you come in front of them, you should not speak this way. How are you? You should not speak. If you understand the gravity of Guru Tattva, you should not speak this way. Those are ordinary people, they are maintaining their human, you know, etiquette. How are you, Gurudev? You idiot. Gurudev always, okay, he is like you, human being, you are asking this way. So in front of Guru Vaishnav, you must be very careful. Very careful you must be. Before speaking anything, better you keep silence. If you speak all rubbish, it's bad. You don't know how to speak, so you are speaking, how are you, Gurudev? Gurudev always happy, always okay. So you see, your coming here is, I think, very good, very nice. I think very, you know, with, you know. So, those who are mumuksha, they are doing different kind of vrata, taking bow. From childhood, actually, from boyhood also. So you are all powerful. So what kind of question I can put in front of you? How are you? This kind of question is not at all applicable here. It is not applicable. I cannot ask this way because you are all realized soul, you know, high powerful. And, you know, Swagatam bodhujo sreshta yadbatani mumukshabaha charanti saddaya dhira balaivo brihanti vai. Different kind of sadhu, those who are taking different kind of, you know, Asterian pranayams, they're leading their life very powerfully. They are also feeling comfortable. So what to speak about? How are you? How you are coming here? I should not see. Kachit naraha kusalam natha indriyarthartho vedinam vyasana vyasana vapo tasmin patitanam sakaramavi. Those who are bonded souls, they are sometimes falling down, up and down is there in their life. So, kochitna kusalam natha indiyarthartho vedinam vas machan vyasanavapo etasmin patitanam sakarmabhi. Ah. So you see, those who are bonded soul according to their, you know, activities, they are getting up and down. They are getting, they in that case, they are the question of good, mangal coming. But for you, this kind of mangal, how are you, how mangal, this kind of question is not at all applicable. It's not good. Okay, anyway, now Prithu Maharaj, Bhavatsu kusala prasno atma rameshu neshate, neshate no ishate. Bhavatsu kusala prasno atma rameshu. Because you are all Atmaram. Atmaram, I definition I already told you, you should remember. Atmani ramate ya sa Atmaram. Atmani means who is getting satisfaction inside himself, who is satisfied himself, is called Atmaram. So, Bhavatsu kusala pasnu atma rameshu no ishate. It is not applicable here, the question. How are you? This question is not applicable. Bhavatsu kusala prasno atma rameshu neshate. Kushala kushala yatrona santi mati vritaha. Kushal, good or bad. No question of good and bad can come in your life. So I should not put a question like a foolish. But I am very lucky, I know you are coming in front of me. So I am going to get the highest benefit today. I am going to get the highest benefit today. Very lucky I am. Now you see, Sanatkumar, they started speaking, oh Rajan, you are very intelligent. You see, Sadhu Prishtam Maharaja Sarva Bhuto Hite Rataha. Hey Rajan, you are putting such a question. It is an international question. Oh, the whole world can get benefit out of your question. You can remember I was speaking, and second canto, you have Parikhit in front of Parikhit Maharaj, Gurudev, Paramahansa Shrestha, topmost Paramahansa, Sukadev Goswami, Gurudev speaking this way. Eh? Gurudev speaking in front of Shishya. Baryane sate prasno krito loko hitane. Sukadev Goswami glorifying his Shishya. So nice Shishya, he's excellent. He's speaking. Second canto first, you can remember. You should hear repeatedly. Baryane sate prasno kito loko hito nipa. Atmabid sanmatu pungsam sotabhyadisu ya paraha. Purikhit Maharaj in front of Purikhit Sukhdev Goswami saying. Baryane sate prasno kito loko hito nipa. Atmabid sanmataha pungsam sotabhyadisu ya paraha. Hey Rajan, you are putting such an excellent question. The whole world can get benefit out of that. Baryan, Baryan means the topmost question. Honorable question. Baryan is a te prasno. Te mean your question is very excellent. Unparalleled, unbeaten and excellent. And yeah, it's an international question. The whole world can get benefit out of that. Atmabit Sanmada, at the same time, it is your question is just approved by all realized soul in this whole universe. Atmabit Sanmata Pungsam. Atmabit means those are realized soul all over this universe. They approve your question, very exact question. Those sadhu, they are expecting this kind of question from you, everybody. Why this kind of question not coming in front of Sadhu Guru Vaishnava? Why people there in Mott Mandir here, they are feeling relaxed? Why not they are feeling tension that we are not doing bhajan properly? Why they are allowing all rubbish thing to happen there? Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda crying. For this I bring Gauriya Mott in this material world from Vaikuntha. For this reason that you can get some benefit, material benefit. Foolish. Gauriya Mad is equal to Vrindavan, Yogopit of Vrindavan. Divyad Vindaran Nukalpadramadam Simadat Naga Singha Sanustu Shishiraha Silakim Govinda de Bhupestali Visep Manusmana. This is the excellent place which we call Gauriya Mad. Gauriya Mad coming here for us to deliver us. So foolish. Sadhu Prishtam Maharaja Sarva Bhuto Hitatmana Bhavata Vidusa Chapi Sadhunam Matiridrishi. Those who are excellent sadhu, they can have that kind of fine intelligence here. Matiruna Krishne Parado Satova Mitho Vipaddeta Ghyapatanam. I can speak this sloka, seventh canto. Motir na kishne parto shatova mitho vipadde to giho vratanam adant govir vishatam tamisram punaha punaha charvito charvananam. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. The same thing you can hear coming. Your brain is very nice. When? Fine intelligence. When it is going to touch the lotus feet of Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan. Otherwise, you are very intelligent, but you are not actually intelligent. Bhagavan says, in 11th canto, I can show you. Bhagavan says, in front of Uddhav, speaking, Uddhav, who is actually intelligent, you know? Who is? Uddhav, who is intelligent, you know? Huh? Uddhav asking, Prabhu, who is actually intelligent? Prabhu, what do you think? Huh? What do you think? I'm very intelligent. Or you are very intelligent? Having so much education? Huh? Who is intelligent? Who is intelligent? Those who are having this material life, man is not, you know, man is mortal. Man is going to die. So any time can die. So after taking bath, if they are thinking over and again, over and again, somehow I have to do Krishna bhajan. Esha buddhi matam buddhi manisha cha manishinam yat satyam anrite neha marthena apnati amritam. There is an answer by Sri Krishna. Who is intelligent? Who is intelligent? Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in front of them. Esha buddhimatam buddhi manisha cha manishinam yat satyam anrite neha martena apnati amritam. He is actually intelligent, Uddhav, who is going to get the nectar. That nectar. He is actually intelligent. He is doing all it, you know, trying over again. Yes, he is actually intelligent. Actually, ordinary man, they can deserve. You are intelligent in your own way. According to your own estimation, you are intelligent. I have nothing to do. You can say, Maharaj, I am also intelligent. Yes, you are intelligent. Whole world can speak this way. But Bhaktivinoda is speaking, they are intelligent in their own way. I am not speaking, I am not going to fight with them. according to your own estimation, you are intelligent. According to my estimation, I am also intelligent. But Krishna cannot approve it. Bhagavan Sri Krishna cannot approve. When Krishna can approve it? Approve? Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, Esha buddhi matam buddhi manisha cha manishinam yat satyam anrite neha martena apnati amritam. If you can get that nectar, after getting this material life, very shortly we are going to live this material world. But the whole world can remember us if we can do bhajan properly. Right? So in Sanskrit one word is there. Kirtir yasso sajivati. He is actually man is mortal. But he is not mortal. Who is, you know, doing all nice activities of Krishna bhajan. Putting all, you know, vivid example. Kirtir yasso. Kirti means all remarkable you know, thing he is doing in this world. After his death, Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, Prabhupada gone, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj gone, Paramahansa, you know, Madhava Goswami Maharaj gone, Paramahansa Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj gone, Paramahansa Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj gone, but who is going to forget them? Everybody can remember them. Kirtir Yasso Sajivati. Who is doing a remarkable achievement in materials, many spiritual achievement, not the material, billions of dollars. You know. So now, Sanakadi is singing, very nice advice, you see. Sangha maho kalu sadhunam uvay shancha sanamataha yat sambhasana sang prashno sarvesham vitano tisam. As sangamaha khalu sadhunam uvaye uvaye shancha sanmataha. If one sadhu sangam, if I get sadhu sangha, it is not, it is so powerful, any court, any way I cannot speak that my sadhu sangha is useless. No. Sadhu sangha is anyhow, it's, you know, useful. Anyway, if you are not kapat, if you are not committing any apradh, but sadhu sangha cannot go vain. Sadhu sangha can never go vain. Those tattabid, they are speaking like you can take poison. A reaction you will have to suffer because just now you take poison. Same thing if you are take nectar without knowing, you have to suffer. So if you are getting sadhu sangha, so anyway you are going to get result. Astu eva rajan bhavato madudisaha padarvindasya gunanubadane ratir durapa vidunoti nashtiki kamam kasayo malamantaratmanaha. He Rajan, Madhusudan Hari Padar Bindu, if I glorify his lotus feet, yes, it's very rare, Sudurlabha. You can get, you know, we can get rare rati, mane attraction, you know. Sudurlabha ikantike rati vidyaman. He Rajan, your heart is full of, you know, bhakti. He Rajan, astu eva rajan bhavato. Astu, mane I, Chatusan speaking, he Rajan, your heart is full of bhakti. Astu eva rajan bhavato madudishaha padar vindusso gunanu vadane ratir durapa vidunoti nashtiki kamam kashayo malamantvaratmanaha. Actually, Rajan, I find your heart is full of bhakti, this kind of rati. You are doing bhakti and to the lotus feet of the Aravinda Aksha, Padaravinda, Vindasya, Gunanubade, you are always ready to hear and speak about the lotus, you know, about this Supreme Lord. So anyway, naturally, your heart is very clean. Vidunoti nashtiki kamam. Tremendously. You have strong affinity. So, that kind of affinity, if somebody develops inside heart, no question of any dirty thing there inside heart. No question, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Cheta Darpana Marjanam already told. So, his option is quite natural. So, very nice, actually, they are going to advise very nice way. One by one, they are speaking so nice, you know, sloka. Nataha parataro loke pungso sartho vetikramaha jadadhyanasso priyastamatmanaho sa vetikramad. So, Why people love each other? Can you see? Can you say? Why your mother love you? Why son loving mother? Why husband loving wife? Why? What's the reason? Why? Mutually they love each other in this material society you can find. Though it is not perfect, but still. Because Atma, O Supreme Lord, hey Rajan, this is because Paramatma is there. If Supreme Lord is not there inside your heart, who is going to love you? Who can love? And one mother, loving son. But if someday son dying, no life is there, who is going to love that son? Up to now, mother loving, but when body, life gone, then mother bound to throw him out. So you see, Atma Vai Paninam, Atma Vai Paninam, I forget the slogan, very nice. And this is actually, so, 32 slogan. So everything love each other because Atma is there. Natoho parataro loke pungsaha swarthavati kramaha jad jadadhyanasso prayastam atmanaha swavati kramat. Atma ke, you know, I forget the sloka from one issue. Very nice sloka. I can remember. Very nice. So, Atma is there. That's why each and we are loving each other. If Atma is not there, who is going to love? So, actually, you see, this way, Chatusan giving so nice, you know, tattva vijnan. Arthendi artha vidhyanat sarvartha po. Bhuchen, arthendiyarthavidhyanam, sarvartapo hannavo ninam, brahmsito jnana vijnanad, jenavishati mokshatam. Actually, dhan, you know, all property there, riches, gold, jewel, everything, all ornaments there, huge amount of money. But if you think this wealth, riches can give you satisfaction, I can prove it's not that. I can give example. It's not that you are speaking false. If you think this way, wrong way, that all this property, you know, this, you know, riches can give me, you know, full satisfaction, it's not good. It's not perfect. I can give you one example. In France, long ago, one king, long ago, maybe 4,000, 3,000, 2,000 years back, I cannot speak. That king, he was very, you know, he wanted to get gold, more and more, more gold. All the time thinking about gold. Gold and so many gold there. Let's say in that wonderful. One day he started doing bhajan about Gandharva. Gandharva came. Oh king, what do you want? Angel. One angel came. I want gold. You bless me so that if I touch anything, it becomes gold. Then the angel said, okay, I bless you. Okay, then gone. After that, you know, cookman cooking everything. After that, he is going to get a dinner, anything. When he is touching food, bread become gold, water become gold, everything gold. He is crying day and night, bed become gold, bed when he gets to sleep. Then he is crying, why this guy, I don't need gold. Then the angel come, what happens king, I don't need gold anymore. Why you told me you need gold? That's why I give you. So, you know, in Arab, one very nice, you know, one nice story there in Arab, Arabian country. There is, you know, There are 40 dacoits, in full troops. They are, you know, going here and there and stealing everything, breaking everything. One day, one poor man took decision to go secretly, go there, and can enter into the cave there, where all jewels and gold, you know, coin, you know, they store there. Somehow, if I can get enter there, so I can collect all. I'm very poor. So he took decision, very secretly I can stay in forest and hear the mantra, how they are opening there the cave. There is some mantra. When they speak mantra, the cave open. After they enter, after that when they are going out, they close. They very secretly is hearing by the mantra. They hear, chiching, pak! They open, they enter. After doing everything, taking rest, everything, sleeping, after taking food, they are going out. After that, you know, again speaking this way. After that, chiching phag means opening. Phag means opening. After that, that man took decision, after those dacoits gone, he take entry, going inside, and he is laughing, Allah, Allah, very good. I am getting everything. He is laughing, taking golds and, you know, taking baths with golds. Ah, very nice. Today I am the richest man. And he is all, you know, sack, filling all gold coin, everything, diamond, everything. After that, now he want to open that cave, to go out. He's saying, what is that mantra? He cannot remember. He is speaking alu phak chiching. He cannot remember anything. He is speaking all rubbish. But that cave is not opening. Now he is crying. The dacoit second coming. He is opening. Allah, I don't want anything. You get me free. But dacoits, they are entering and with sword cutting his throat. Ah! This is the result. If you feel attraction for material wealth and riches, that is the, you know, ultimate result. So this way, you see, those who are actually thinking about gold and riches, everything, they unknowingly, they are actually expecting this kind of, you know, this kind of thing, because Atma is there. If I make you king, then a desert, you see, big desert, nobody there, no prani. I make you king there. What you can do there? Nothing to do. So, actually, knowingly and unknowingly, we are doing everything. We love each other because Atma is there. So this way, so you see, if you can understand this technology, I mean this, you know, tattva-gyan, then you can, you know, go out of this material bondage. Otherwise, no question. So this way, actually, Sanatkumar giving so many advice so nicely. After that, Sanatkumar speaking very nicely. Yatpada pankaja palasa bile bilasa bhakta karma sayam gratitamad gathayanti santo tadbatna riktamat yo yatayo opi ruddho srutagana astamaranam bhajavasudevam. Yahar Pathpadmir Anguli Daler Kantamati. They know there is a Bhagavan Supreme Lord is all light, you know, coming out of as a nail, a lotus feet. Yat Pad Pankajo Palas Vilas Bhaktya Karma Sayam Grathitamadgrathayanti santo, you know, when those Rishi Manish and all those who are doing bhajan, they concentrate, they are thinking about that lotus feet, they can cut all material bondage very easily. If we think about the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, Yar Pat Padme Ungri Kanti Matma, they cannot, you know, they cannot stay in this material world. They are like to cut the material bondage there, if they think about that lotus feet. Yat Pada Pankaja Palas Bilas Bhaktya, out of their strong devotion, they think about that lotus feet. Automatically, it is quite natural they can cut all material bondage inside their heart. Tadbat no rikta matayo yatayo pi. So, you know, easily they can cut material bondage, very easily. So, this way actually, Chatuswan speaking all nicely, after that you see, Prithu Maharaj took decision to leave this material world. Now Prithu Maharaj, after hearing from Chatuswan, he took decision to go to Badrikasram to do bhajan nicely, going there. Archi Devi also going there. After that, finally, you know, leave body. After that, on pyres, you know, pyre, you know, the place where dead body is kept. It's called pyre, not pyres. Pyre means the place where, in Kimmeridian ground, there is one place where dead body is kept first, after that wooden structure, after that there is shit fire. That's called pyre. The Orchi Devi somehow put the body of husband on pyre, and wooden, all wooden structures set fire, and fire glowing on. Orchi Devi himself enter into that fire, and living body with husband, and going to get the same place where his husband going to, this way you see, this way actually, Orchi Devi also living body there. After that you see, Prithu Maharaj, as you see, after that, Prithu Maharaj, I already told, Prithu Maharaj's son who? I told you, Prithu Maharaj's son Utkal. But he wanted to prove that I am crazy, so second son, Batso, was, So now, Prithu Putto, his name is Bijitasso. I already told. Bijitasso, you know? Bijitasso already told the meaning. When Indra Maharaj is disturbing Jagya, he is flying with the horse of Jagya, then the son of, Prithuputta, Bijitasso. Bijitasso means he is chasing Indra, leaving the horse and flying. He take the horse back, that's why his name is Bijitasya. Then after that, Bijitasya, after for so long time, he is ruling the world, whole world. After some time, he developed detachment. He giving the responsibility unto lotus feet of Havirdhan, second son, Havirdhan, because first gone. And Havidhan, second son. Dhruvaputta, actually, Dhruvaputta was Utkal. I forget and confused. Dhruvaputta was Utkal, I already told. But here I confuse now. I am speaking about Prithu Maharaj. The first son of Dhruva Maharaj was Utkal, second son was Batso. I forget, I confuse. Excuse me. And now I am speaking of Prithu Maharaj, his son is Vijitasya. So, the Vijitasya, after so long time, he is ruling. After that, he is developing, you know, strong detachment, so leaving and going to forest to do Hari Bhajan. Previously, on those ancient days, you can find all big, big kings. They used to stay for some time. After that, it was that they used to leave. Here also, Vijitasu, after some time, is ruling. He developed detachment. After leaving, he is giving responsibility to second son of Prithu. First son is Vijitasu. He is ruling for some time. After that, the second son of Prithu, Havirdhan, he became king. His son is Pracinabarhi. Pracinabarhi is a big personality in the way. He used to do yagya, countless yagya. Pracinabarhi. His same is Pracinabarhi. Pracinabarhi the king now at present. Havirdhan, after Vijitasya, Havirdhan was made king. After Havirdhan, his son, Pracinabarhi, he was interested to do yagya, countless yagya. Not only fire sacrifice, he used to, you know, slaughter, yes. Countless pashu, beast. Yes. Pracinabarhi used to rule his, kingdom very nicely. After that, he got four sons. His name is Pracetas. He got four sons at a time. Pracetas. Then Pracinabarhi is speaking that I am now aged. I like to give responsibility to you all. So you can enter into family life and you can increase the population here in this world. Ho Pracetas, now I am aged. Prachetagon speaking, Father, we will have to go to for estate and finances first. We can do an bhajan, yoga. For after that, we can lead family life. Is good. We like to get power first. Father say, okay, you go. Then 10 sons of Pracinabarhi, their name is Pocheta. All ten sons of Pracinabarhi, the two. Four sons, their name is Pracetas. 10 sons. Pracetas, they took decision to do bhajan first. After that, we can get power. Then we can do, we can carry out your order to enter into family life, increase the population. Well, we can do first. We like to go to forest. Actually, they are going to western, sea, Arab Sagar, Eastern Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea. Prachatagon first went towards western, place. Gradually they were walking at the bank of Samudra Sea. They are doing bhajan, but they all on a sudden they find, Shivji Maharaj, very nice looking, coming out of a water lake, one nice lake. From there, Sivji Maharaj coming out very nicely. And with them, all his, all his parshad there, ghost there. They playing, somebody playing drum, somebody being dum 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 dum, somebody doing musical tune. Then Sivji Maharaj coming out very nicely in front of Pracetas. Oh, Pracetas gone. What you are doing? See, I am coming in front of you. My darshan is excellent darshan. Nobody going to lose. You are going to gain something excellent because I come in front of you. I am happy with you. But this way you are doing hard, astuti and penances. No, no, you come. I can bless you. I can give you nice Gita. Gita means song. If you go on reciting this song, Supreme Lord can come in front of you. You can get the benefit. Nice? So you try to hear it. So this way, Shankar Bhagavan blessing them and speaking the Gita, which is called Rudra Gita. There are so many Gita. Gita means Actually, Gita means you think Bhagavad Gita. Gita, this term, we use this word. Why? Gita means already song. Sung by some. Sung by somebody. So, Gita is also, Bhagavad Gita is also Gita. It's sung by Krishna. Yes, Shankar Bhagavan singing, so Rudra Gita. We can hear Benu Gita, Gopi Gita, so many Gita there. We can get so many Gita. So here is also Gita, Rudra Gita. So now, in front of Prachin, you know, Prachin, the son of Pracinabarhi, Pracheta, ten Pracheta, they are sitting in front of Sriji Maharaj. Shivaji Maharaj speaking all Rudra Gita, very excellent way. Now, actually, ten thousand years they are doing tapasya, doing bhajan. It is written, Pitradishta praja sarge tapase arnavam avishan. Daso sahasso, daso varsha sahasrani tapasarchang tapaspatim. But jaduktam pathi dishtena girishena prasidata tad dhyanto japantasya pujayantasya sangyata. First of all, Girish, Shankar Bhagavan. Shankar Bhagavan blessing them, giving see. After they enter into ocean, under ocean they are doing bhajan very nicely, 10,000 years. Now, Vidhuji Maharaj, you don't confuse, get confused. Now again we are coming here, Maitreya Muni speaking to Vidhuji Maharaj. This sequence already spoken by, you know, Naimishchetra. In Naimishchetra, Shutadev Goswami is speaking to Sanakadi Rishi. This incident, again actually, Parikshit Maharaj, in front of Parikshit Maharaj, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking this way, sequence. Now, where from Vidhuji Maharaj coming? Well, you cannot, you know, remember. Actually, this sequence actually is Maitreya Muni speaking to Vidhuji Maharaj. Vidhuji Maharaj vacho, Prachetasam giritreno jathasit pati sangama. Jaduta haraha pritastanno brahman badarthavat sangamaha khalu viprarse shiveneha saririnam durlabo munayo dadhyura sangyad jamabhipsitam. It is expected. All bandhat sivs should expect a meet with Siva. But the meeting with Siva is not a matter of joke. Whenever somebody meeting with Siva, the Vaishnavanam Jathasambhu, surely they are going to get great benefit, spiritual improvement. I also got kippa from Sivaji Maharaj. That's why I am trying to do bhajan. You see, so Vidhuji Maharaj asking, so what kind of, you know, discussion took place between Pracheta, those ten Pracheta and Shankar Bhagavan, and how different way Shankar Bhagavan was bound to advise in front of, giving advice to those Pracheta. Because Sangamaho Kholubi Prodse Sive Neho Dehinam, is the meeting with Siva is not a matter of joke. Durlabo Muniyo Dadhur Asangya Adijama Vipsitam. You know, if you like to get detachment, if you like to grow your, you know, attraction to lotus feet of Krishna, it's sama durlabo munayo, you know, durlabo munayo, you know. For this bonded soul is a rare thing. It's rare. Atma Rama upi yastu asyo loko kalpa saradhase Saktya yukto vichoroti ghoraya bhagavan bhavo. Is Shankar Bhagavan is Atmaram. Is Shankar Bhagavan is Atmaram, you see? He is always Atmaram, Paramahansa. But still, by the order of Supreme Lord, even he is bound to take the charge of Tamagun. What to do? It is the order of Supreme Lord. So he is bound to take charge of that Tamagun destruction. But don't think it otherwise. He is Vaishnavanam Yatha Sambhu. I already told. Nimnaganam Yatha Ganga Divanam Achyuto Yatha Vaishnavanam Yatha Sambhu Purananam Tidam Bhagavatam Atmaramo Pijastu Asya Loko Kalpasya Radhase Sakta Yukto Charati Ghora Ghoraya Bhagavan Bhava. So Bhagavan Bhava taking control over this, you know, in charge of this Tamaguna, so what? No problem. Maitro Vacho. So now they gone, you know, Maitro Vacho. Prachetasaha piturvakyam sirasa adayo sadabaha disyam pratichyam prajajus tapasyadrita chetasaha. Tapasyadrita chetasaha. From heart they wanted to do tapasya. That's why by the order of father they took decision. Okay, we are going to obey you. We are not going to violate you, father. First, they started going towards western part. Western part, you see? She. Arabian Sea. So, prachetasaha pitur bhakyam sirasadayo. They give honor to the father's order. Father, we can carry out, no problem. But first, disham pratichim prajajur tapasyadrita chetasaha. Tapasyadrita chetasaha, divas. Yeah, he was very eagerful to do tapasya bhajan from heart. That's why it is in prajaju majadisham pratishim prajajur tapasya drita chetasaha. After that, going at the bank of sea, sumudram, after that, where is sumudram, upo vistirnam apashyan sumahat saraha. Near that, you know, sea, ocean, they find a nice sarovar, very nice lake of water, very nice. They actually, nice sarovar, very nice, you know, clean. Prasanna salilasa sachan. After that, they are waiting there for some time, doing something. After that, Shankar Bhagavan coming out of that lake, Siti Kancham. Tapto Hemo Nikabhayam Siti Kancham Trilochanam Prasad Sumukham Bhikshu Pranemur Jato Kautukaha. Actually, from that pond, I mean that from that water lake, Shivji Maharaj Siti Kantha. Coming on his, this portion is actually Nil. Shankar Bhagavan name, another name is Nilkantha, Pinaki, Durjati, Sambhu, Shiv. So many names. Shiti Kantha means this portion is blue color, this like peacock. Why? At the time of in churning of ocean, Samudramanthan, poison came. Shankar Bhagavan took all poison, but Shankar Bhagavan don't allow to go this poison inside body heart because Krishna is sitting there, Krishna can feel pain. Up to this point, Shankar Bhagavan keeping this poison. This poison is confined here, cannot come, get lit, get outlet to go inside to give pain to Krishna. He don't allow up to that. That's why from then we all say Nilakantha, Siti Kantha. This way. Follow? I can discuss this point after. You see? So after that, they meeting with, you know, Tapto Hemo Nivhakayam Siti Kantham Tilochanam Prasanno Sumukham Bhikshu Pranamyur Jato Kautukaha. They become very interested. They become very eagerful to see what? Oh, so nice! Shankar Bhagavan coming, paying dandavad, everything. Then Shankar Bhagavan speaking, yo, he can come out successful by my blessing. I am going to speak some Gita. I am going to speak. It's called Rudra Gita. You can recite, and if you go on doing bhajan, then very shortly mean, we are only going to live 100 years. That time they are giving 1 lakh years. It's short time for them. So, you know, this way Rudra Bhagavan now speaking. You try to remember it, you know, Rudra Bhacho. Jitam to atmo. Jitam to atmo vid. Dhuryo sastaye sastirastume. Bhavatar adhaswaswardham. Sarvasmatmane namaha. Namo pankajanabhayo. Bhuta sakshmendriyatmane. Pasu devayo santayo. Kutasthayo sarochi se sankarsanayo sukshmayo durantayantukayacha sankarsanayo sukshmayo durantayantukayacha namo visho prabodhayo pradunnamnayantoratmani namo namo anurudhayo rishikeshendriyatmani Namo Paramahansayo Purnayo Nibhritatmane 36, 24 Adhyay Sargap Bargo Darayo Nityam Suchi Sadi Namaha Namo Hiranavirjayo Chatur Hotrayo Tantabi Namo Ujjo Ishetaryapate Yagaretase Tripti dayo cha jivanam namo sarvarasatmane sarvo satyatmo dehayo visheshayo stabiyase namastrailakyo palayo saho ojo balayo cha artho lingayo navase nabo antar vahiratmane namaha punnayo lokayo omusmai bhurivarchase Prabhittaya nebrittaya pitridevaya karmane Namo adharma vipakayo mrittabe dukchadaya cha Namaste ashishamisho manabe karunatmane Namo dharmaya brihate krishnayo kuntabedase Purushaya purna purushaya puranayo Shankho yogeswarayate This way Going on glorifying Supreme Lord in different ways is called Rudra Gita. For a long time. After that, you see, Shankar Bhagavan speaking in a nice way. After they giving so many advice, so many nice. And here you can get this also nice what we are speaking very often. Sadhu Sanga, Sadhu Sanga, Sarva Sastri Koi. Labamattu sadhu sanghe sarvasi, this sadhu. You can glorify. Khanardhe napi tulayena sargam na punar bhavam. Bhagavat sanghi sanghe samarta nam kimuta sisaha. Satsanga, glorification of satsanga. Satsanga is so rare. 57 sloka of 24 adhyay chapter. It's very nice. Satsango labhate pungmir bhavir sukriti purva sanchitai. It is not a matter of joke that you are getting satsanga. You search your past life, you can find that for thousands of lives you are searching satsanga. Not a matter of it's in Shastra Bhagavat. Satsanga prapate pungvir bahuvir sukriti purva sanchitoi. All sukriti accumulated life after life. Now this life you are getting satsanga. And Tulsidasji, what speaking? Tulsidasji, you know Tulsidasji? No? Writing Ramayana? Oh, so nice. Very tasty Ramayana. Balmiki Ramayana, not so taste. You know? Though he is Balmiki. He is Valmiki himself. But this life, Tulsidas ji is Valmiki, previously. Valmiki Muni. He wrote Ramayana. Tulsidas is singing this way. Very nicely. You cannot understand, it is Hindi. You cannot understand what to speak easily. Hindi actually. See, if I speak, no use. Very nice. Bina Guru Baba Nidhi Sattaraina Kui. Bina Guru Baba Nidhi Taraina Kui. Nobody can cross this material world without the kripa of Guru. Without the kripa of Guru, you cannot. Binu satsanga tarai na koi. Binu satsanga tarai na koi. Ram kipa binu sulab na soi. Very nice, Hindi. Very nice tone. Binu satsanga tarai na koi. Ram kipa binu sulab na soi. Ram kipa binu sulab na soi. You cannot get without the kipa of Ram. Ram means Supreme Lord. Binu satsang taraina koi Ram kipa binu sulab na soi. It is also granted by Krishna. That's why you are getting satsanga. It is when Krishna approved, then you can. I have money power, I can get sadhu sanga. Oh, call all sadhu. You are idiot number one. You cannot get anyone sadhu. Sadhu going to fly from that place. Yeah. I have so much money. I have heard one people speaking. Oh, we can pay pranami, so we can get sadhu. Ah, you can get sadhu by pranami. You are number one, you know, foolish. And those who are coming, they are also number one foolish. Khanardhe na pitulaye na sargam na punarbhavam bhagavat sangya sangasso martanam kimudasi saha. What kind of benefit you can expect other than sadhu sangha? Sadhu sangha is topmost. One fraction of second I can, sadhu sangha, one fraction of sadhu sangha, I cannot compare this, you know, with another dan, donation, STT and finances, so many things. I cannot compare. Sadhu Sangha is so powerful. No. Sadhu Sangha is so powerful, you see. Because? Why Sadhu Sangha is so powerful? Why? Why Sadhu Sangha is so powerful? Why? I already told yesterday, nobody can see. Nobody can speak. I told you yesterday. Satang prasangyad mama birja sangvita. Satang prasangyad mama birja sangvita. Bhavanti hitkarna rasayana kataha. Tajyosanad asu apavarga vatmani. Sadhya bhakti rati ranukramishati. So this way you are going to get maximum most benefit. Not maximum benefit. Maximum, most benefit you can get out of Sadhu Sangha. Even Krishna can come in front of me, but still I can give honor to Sadhu first. Because Krishna is not going to speak anything about himself. Padunna is Mr. speaking, Prabhu, in front of Chaitanya, Prabhu, I like to hear Harikatha from you. Prabhu speaking, I don't know Harikatha, you can go to Raya Ramananda. So Prabhu not going to speak anything about himself. So better we can get, because no problem, Harikatha is equal to Hari. The Siddhanta is that like Gopika, there's Gopika crying in front of, you know, that Brahma, you know, black beast. Hey, black beast, I know you are very shrewd, clever. Go. But anyway, Krishna gone to Mathura, it's okay. But still we cannot leave his topics. Topics is there. The topics of Krishna is there with us. Always singing and hearing the topics. Eh? It is still there. Gopikas, they are crying. Krishna gone. Okay, Krishna gone. The topics of Krishna Harikatha is there. That is equal to Hari. So you see, so we want to, actually Vittasura also. Vittasura, we can in sixth canto we can see. Vittasura also singing in front of, you know, Anantadev, Sankarsan. Mamo Uttama Sloka Janish Saksham Videhi. Uttama Sloka Janish, I want to get friendship with your devotees, life to life. This way. This way actually so many things you see. Shankar Bhagavan speaking. Now after that you see, after that is a Prachin, Pracinabarhi here, because those son, Pracinabarhi, his 10 son Pracheta, they are gone to do STT and Pinance. 10,000 years not a matter of joke for you and me. But for them, doing bhajan for some time. Because they are 1 lakh year minimum, they are going to live. So they are for 10,000 years doing bhajan inside sea. After getting the kippa of Shankar Bhagavan, they enter into sea and doing bhajan nicely for 10,000 years. After that, here in the meantime, Pracinabarhi, he is very disturbed because son gone, my 10 son gone, not coming back. They promised me to come back and lead their family life, but still now he is not coming back. What to do? But still, it is his usual habit to do sacrifice, I mean, pasu, beast, in each and every jagga, cutting, pasu. One day Narad coming in front of you, oh Pracinabarhi, oh Prabhu, come, hey, this is Jiva. Now I have one question, what question? You are doing countless jagga. Yes, I am doing. But what is the ultimate result? What is the net outcome? You think? No. I like to do jagga. Actually, you are foolish. Countless pasu, beast you are, you know, slaughter, you are, you know, cutting. Those jivatma, they are waiting to cut you again. You know? Be careful, Rajan. Who, really? Yes! They are waiting with sharp, you know, knife and, you know, sword to cut you. Whenever you leave your body, you will have to take thousands of births and they are also going to cut you. Be careful, Rajan. Oh, really? So painful life here, but no solution. No solution? What to do? Very dangerous, you see? Those jivatma, you are cutting them, you are cutting their throat in and doing jagga nicely. Mangsha, you know, meat. You in English, you see meat. But we say in Sanskrit and Bengali, mangsha. Mangsha khadati. Mang, hane. Now at present, this life, he is eating me. But next life, I am going to eat you. Eat him. Mangsha means mangsha khadati. This life he is eating me, cooking and eating me. But next life this year, I am going to cook him and kick. So monks are very careful, very dangerous. See, this way, Naruji Maharaj coming, oh Rajan, you should think over and again what you are doing, rubbish. Oh really? Then what is the solution? First of all, I like to speak one nice history. History? My story. Nice story? Yes. Nice story I like to speak you. What story? It is called Puranjan Upakshan. It's Puranjan Upakshan, very nice Upakshan, but through this story, it is not actually a fictitious story. It seems that it is a fictitious story. In Arabian country, in different place, you know, where in Greece, you can get some, you know, fictitious stories. But it is not actually fictitious. Through this story, you can get outcome, very nice outcome. In Greece, Italy, here, there, again, the nice, you know, story there. know. But that story is all fictitious, not actual story. But here actually, though Naraji wanted to give one, speak one story, but the actual motive of Naraji is to, through this story, he wanted to illustrate the position in which he is at present put it into. I mean, Pracinabarhi. Because some they are still today not coming back. In the meantime, this happens, you see. In the meantime, this happens. Then Naraji Maharaj is going to speak this story. Hey, Rajan, very carefully you try to hear this point, what I am going to speak. Okay. You know, then Pracinabarhi hearing this story. You know, then Pracinabarhi hearing the story, Naraji speaking, Naraji nicely speaking, you see, Puranjan, one personality, he is searching, he is, you know, running here and there in Panchal desh. Panchal means Punjab, but here Panchal means we can see the, you know, the place where you can get some enjoyment of your five sense organ. Shabda sparsho rup rasgandho. Shabda means sound, sparsho touch, rup beauty, rasa, and gandha smell. The five, those are the five basic elements of enjoyment. If you search from Napoleon Bonaparte up to you, if you search everybody, you can sign those are the five basic elements which behind their enjoyment. Any kind of enjoyment, any people, anywhere, any time want to get, those are the five basic elements they want to get. Shabda sparsho rupa rasa gandha. This is actually fictitious, not actually fictitious story. This is not allegory. Very nice. It looks like allegory. But now, Naraji speaking, Puranjan, one very, you know, greedy personality, is having so much of desire, you know. His search is, you know, traveling here and there in Panchal desh. Panchal desh is the place where you can get facility of this, you know, enjoyment of five kind of enjoyment. Now, by chance, while he is traveling, he find one nice building. Maharaji Maharaj speaking, in course of his traveling, somehow, someday he find a nice building, like guest house, very nice, like palace. Oh, it's nice place, it's back end. I should get entry here and clean and stay here. He took entry, and living there for a long time. Hey, enjoying nice. But inside that room, that palace, he find one nice, beautiful girl. Very pretty girl. Oh, he make friendship with her. Oh, you must stay with me. We can enjoy both very nicely. Started enjoyment, very nice, excellent enjoyment started. After that, someday, somehow, Candavega, and Nam, one, you know, attack that building. Is almost now in dilapidated condition. This building, this rod coming out of building, this is now in for a long time is enjoying. Now building is dilapidated, need repairing. Who is going to repair? After that, you see, Candavega, Gandharva attack. 360 Gandharva at a time attack that building. Hey, you go out. It is our place. So long I am enjoying here very nicely. Nobody came to claim. But who are you to claim? We are. Go. Attack. He like to throw him out. Go. It is our place. 360 Gandharva with Candavega. After that you see, also is very sorry. Kalakanya getting entry. And after that, he like to make friendship. He is staying Javaneshwar. Kalakanya Jara, Javaneshwar. After that, You see, after that, this is the condition of Puranjan. He is helpless, crying, and after this he is going to leave his body. Then Prachin body speaking. I am speaking in gist actually. In detail, Sipa is 7 days I will have to speak. In front of Naraji Maharaj, Prachinabarhi speaking, oh, receiver. Actually, my brain is always, I am always thinking about matter. So I cannot get your point. What do you mean to say? This theory is very nice, but what do you mean to say actually? Naraji Maharaj speaking, oh Rajan. Oh Rajan, you could not realize this point. I want to let me explain it. This Puranjan is this Jivatma. Naraji Maharaj speaking, oh Rajan, you couldn't get my point. Let me explain. This Puranjan is nobody, the Jivatma, with full of desire inside heart. Because subtle body is there. It's called Karan Sarir. If you are not going to live desire, be sure, next life again the subtle body can follow you, put you in different life. You can get another body and go on enjoying this life very nicely. But no end, no solution. So, hey Rajan, Naraji Maharaj speaking, hey Rajan, this Puranjan is nobody, this Jivatma with full of desire inside heart. And what is that palace? He got free? He got entry? That place is a material body. Oh, really? 9 gates there. Material body is called the palace, guest house. Not actually guest house. You wanted to enjoy life. You wanted to take control over that building. But Jivatma has got no bearing over his body and mind. Have any control? You have a control over your body? No. Morning time you are very happy, night time fever. Again, next morning you are getting, you know, malaria. Next time typhoid, cholera, no bearing, no controlling over your inborn body. Mind is also not under your control. Mind is under your control? No. Then what to do? So you see, this body is, you see, material body is called that guest house. It is actually palace where the Jivatma wanted to enjoy and stay in a very relaxed way. But he couldn't realize there is not a permanent place here in this material world. Anything you achieve, you have to leave everything. After they entering that room, he find a nice, you know, lady. Ah, very nice, pretty lady. What is that lady? What is that lady? That is called Buddhi. A Buddhi. Asati Mati. Ah, he is giving advice. Director. In any family you can find, wife is the director. Husband cannot do anything. In any family you go, in Kalikal. Wife is the director. Hey, sit. Hey, go. You can follow. They are bound to follow. It's Kalikal, you see. After that you see, now position is very bad. But for him is very good. For us, very bad. He is making friendship. Friendship means wife. Very nice. Many times he is, you know, going to always try to follow that brain. Is called Asati Mati, a lady. Very nice. Sometimes she become very unhappy, lying on dust. Then Puranjan asking, why you are so unhappy? You want to get some enjoyment, so that's why unhappy. Your brain is also Asati Mati. Asati Mati pros. Asati Mati. Mati actually in Sanskrit also is Strilingo. In Strilingo, Mati Shabda Ru is also Strilingo. This, you know. So Mati is actually Strilingo, feminine gender. This way, you know, now he is feeling relaxed, like to stay there in a very relaxed way. But someday this Gandharva, actually different kind of disease coming. Chandavega. 360 Gandharva attacking. I mean, sometimes you cannot see in eyes. you cannot hear properly, your digestion power gone. This way you are developing divine gap. So it is one kind of bell. Dung. Your death coming. Dung. Dung means one kind of charge, you know, charge. One kind of bell. Dung. Morning chime. That's when your death is approaching. Be careful. So you are developing different kind of disease. Your eyes gone over, out of order. That means one bell gone. Dung. Your ear gone out of order, that's in one bell, dung. This way you are getting one after another bell, get ready. You will have to leave this material world. It's not permanent place. This way you are getting bell, go out. After that, Javaneshwar coming. Javaneshwar is Mithu. Hey, go out. It's our place. Then Javaneshwar taking control over that body is Mithu. Mithu means death. Pracinabarhi government, oh, so excellent thing you are explaining. But I couldn't realize it. So excellent thing. Now I am getting realization. I was put it into such a, you know, bad position. Ignorance, you see. Now I am getting, you know, some advice from you. So I can try to lead my life accordingly. But it's too late actually. It's too late now. But still I can try. I can try my last, you know. Never it is too late. One word is there in English. Never it is too late. For those who are doing to do some bhajan in bhajan, for them, never it is too late. We have one word. Never it is too late. Anytime you can start. So he is going to start. Now actually, those, you know, in the meantime, he is hearing this nice story and developing his consciousness. Oh, Naraji Maharaj, I like to do bhajan nicely. I have done mistake all the way. Whole life full of mistake. My whole life full of mistake. Oh, Naraji Maharaj. Now actually, those Pracetas, ten Pracetas, they are getting power. And after bhajan, they meeting the Supreme Lord. Four hands. In front of Prachitagon, I bless you. After that, getting power, so many things I am speaking in gist. They are coming out of ocean. Coming out of ocean, 10 Pracheta, dasa Pracheta. And they find, what is this? Pracinabarhi gone to forest maybe, and this whole world is full of forest. All trees and, you know, creepers, nowhere to go. It's very dangerous. They become very angry. And from their mouth, they create fire. Fire coming. Hey, clean. There's no place to go. All trees and, you know, all the way, every full blockage. They are creeper and trees, full. Forest, where to go? They create fire from their mouth, started burning all trees. Then all trees, they are appealing mood. Why you are burning us? We have done, we have no place to stay, no place to go. Don't become angry. As per the desire of Krishna, I mean Supreme Lord, because already by this time they meet Supreme Lord. I told you, they are doing bhajan 10,000 years under the sea. 10,000 league under the sea. They are doing bhajan. So now, Supreme Lord coming, they say, I bless you all. You can go and do your, lead your family life. I bless you. One daughter I keep for you, choose. You can marry them. You all can marry her. Go up. Now after those trees, how that girl came, this girl actually, there is one nice story, you see. Kandumuni doing bhajan in forest. Somehow, he meet with Promlocha, one, you know, heavenly lady, you know, Apsara. He was attracted. Somehow they are actually association. Then why there? By that time they got by that promlocha apsara, getting the association of that Muni Kandamuni, after getting one baby, that is girl baby. That girl is in a Marish. Those trees, because they are gone, who can take care? Then now those trees, they are somehow taking care of that girl, baby, lady baby. Then Indra Maharaj coming and helping also this way. That Marish, then those trees, when he, those Pracheta, 10 Pracheta going to burn this, you know, trees and, you know, creepers, trees and keepers, then those trees, then appling mood speaking, we keep one daughter for you, his name is Marisha, very nice lady, you can, we can give this, you know, lady to you, you 10 Pracheta can marry her very nicely. Then after that, you see, After that, Marisha, 10 Pracheta, marry at a time. Like Panchabandhav, at a time marry. And first, actually Arjun go. After that, they all fight. This way, actually now, what happens? The Marisha and the 10 Pracheta marry Marisha. After that, from 10 Pracheta, one nice, you know, very powerful personality coming, take birth. His name is Daksha. Huh? Daksha, you already told that time, at the time of, you know, Daksha Jagya? I told you that Daksha is same Daksha, but that time when he commit offense unto the lotus feet of Shankar Bhagavan, maybe after some time he was, you know, doing some stotra in appealing mood, but from heart that aparad was not clear at all. Not 100% clear that time. That's why now he is bound to take birth here as Prachetas Daksha. 10 Pracheta, from them, this Daksha, the Prajapati, Daksha Prajapati coming out, and Daksha, this name given because he is efficient. What question of efficiency coming here? Why is giving this name Daksha? Daksha is giving this name because he is efficient to he is very interested to, you know, about the self interest about this material world made of blood and flesh. Efficient, he can increase this material world. He always thinking the improvement, material improvement. Anybody in this material world always thinking about material improvement, we can say he is also Daksha. Any people in this material world, if he find, is very efficient to get some material benefit, material improvement, we can call, hey Dakshaji Maharaj, you are very efficient. You are not actually, you always try to increase material benefit. So you are Daksha actually. Now Daksha, that same Daksha, now taking birth as a son of Pracheta, 10 Pracheta, in Chakshush Mannanta. So now this Daksha, you know, in this Chakshush Mannanta, also he is making mistake again. But the previous aparad is not clear. Previous aparad is not clear 100%. His smell is there. Again, this life we can discuss this point on sixth canto. How he is, you know, misbehaving with Naraji Maharaj. He is speaking all rubbish to Naraji. You are the only responsible. You only responsibility. You only responsibility. All my son gone. We living this material world. They are not ready to enter into family life. It is for you. I curse you. You cannot stay anywhere at a time. You have to travel here, there. Naraji laughing. It's very nice curse. a sadhu need to travel here and there to get benefit. It's nice. A sadhu is, those bonded souls can get benefit. If I travel, okay, nice. So Naraji Maharaj cannot stay in one place. He's always restless, traveling here, there, everywhere. It's good. Though he is cursing, as one in one way is very nice. Very nice. This way you see, Naraji Maharaj speaking this nice, you know, this way you see. This way actually, Naraji Maharaj speaking Puranjan Upakhan. After this I speak about that to you. What about? About this Prachetagon, about the Daksha. Prachetagon started worshipping his Supreme Lord. That sloka I didn't speak you because very, it will take time. So anyway, I speak already, but still you can hear the sloka one or two. Prachetagon Uchu Namo Namaha Klesa Vinasayo Nirupito Daro Gunaha Hovayo Manu Vacho Vego Puro Jobayo Sarvakshamargoi Ragatadhani Namaha Suddhayo Santayo Namaha Sanishthaya Manasi Apartham Bilasad Bayayo Namo Jagastano Layo Dayeshu Grihito Maya Guno Vigrayayo Vigrahayo Namo Vishuddha Sattayo Haraye Harimedase Vasudevayo Krishnayo Prabhave Sarvo Shattata 24, 30 Udhay. Namo Kamala Nabhayo Namo Kamala Malini Namo Kamala Padayo Namaste Kamale Kshana Namo Kamala Kinjalko Pishangyamala Vasase Sarvabhuta Vina Nivasayo Namo Ajokshmahi Shakshini Namo Ajokshmahi Shakshini Rupam Bhagavata Tu etad asesha klesa sanshayam Abhiskritam na klishtanam kimanya danukampitam. This way you see. Nice. That after that actually Naraji Maharaj first of all meet that Pracinabarhi, the father of all 10 Pracheta. Set me free, out of problem, bondage. Now again, you see, again Naraji Maharaj meeting Pracheta, 10 Pracheta, ho Pracheta gone. You are leading nice family life, it's okay, by the order of your father. But you should know the actual meaning of this family, you know? You are speaking, my father advised us, by the order of father, we are leading this family life, okay. But you know the actual meaning of this family life? So how you can lead perfectly? The Naraji Maharaj speaking, now I can speak some tattva in front of you. You try to hear. Actually, Naraji Maharaj speaking, yeah, very, very nice sloka. Very, very. Out of this tapasya, you have been leading family life, na? Family life is also full of tapasya. If you think the family life is a you know, gate of enjoyment, you are number one idiot. It's not. It is much more tapasya. All the time you have to bear everything. Huh? So you must know the technique. So let me speak. After that, Naraji Maharaj speaking very nicely. You have put it into river. You have put it into such a river. That river is very excellent. There are two kind of flow there. Huh? Two kind of flow? One river, we find one flow in any one direction. But no, Naraji Maharaj, you have put it into such a river which is having two kind of flow. One is right, one is left. Huh? We never hear? That is called Sangsar river. One kind of flow is there, you can go into hell through material enjoyment, another kind of flow, because Jivatma always Tatastha Shakti. You know Tatastha Shakti? Marginal potency. Another flow is there, you can be put it into a very high realm. That current is very nice. Provided you meet one sadhu. Brahmando Brahmite Kunu Bhagavanji Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bish. I can start this point tomorrow morning. Yathataramulni Sechane Natipantitaskandu Bhuju Pusakaha Pranupharascha Yatendriyanam Tateva Sarva Arhanam Arhanam Achuteja. Narajivin is speaking, you know, you are leading family life, foolish. If you offer water unto this, you know, root of any trees, a whole tree can get nourishment. There is the Bhuvanadrum, the root cause of this, you know, tree. Root cause of this tree, you see branches there, this is called material cosmic manifestation, is also one kind of truth. And Gita it is written, Krishna is singing, O Arjuna, urdhamulam adho swakham, urdhamulam adho swakham. This tree is just opposite. His root is the up. Root is just up. Here usually you can find one tree, his root going down and trees up. All, you know, branches and fruits and, you know, leaves, everything up. But that tree is just opposite. Urdhamulam adho swakham. Very unique, fantastic thing. So, Prachin, you know, Prachatagan, if you worship Krishna, the Supreme Lord, all duty done in your life, you don't know. Naraji Maharaj speaking, no duty is there in this material life left for you to discharge. Devarsi bhutatmaninam pitrinam nayam rinich rajana sarvatmanaja saranam saranyam gato mukunda parihitta kartam. Narji Maharaj speaking to Yudhishthira Maharaj, O Rajan, no duty. Devarsi bhutatmaninam pitrinam nayam rinich rajana. Because when you take birth in the material world, you have on some duty, responsibility. Rin. Rin mean? Some debt you will have to pay. Rishidin. How you can pray? Through hearing Harikatha. Rishidin. I mean Shastra. Pitrurin, if you marry and give birth to a boy. Bhutarin, if you, in daily life, if you pay something to different creature, like in water some, you know, water, some food you can give in front of cook, dog, you can give some bread in front of birds, you can give some fried rice, you know, muri, you know, muri, you can give those birds. This way, you can give some sugar for ants. This way, you'll have to discharge some duty. Anyway, you'll have to do. But if you are doing Krishna bhajan, no duty. Nothing duty left, all done, you see. So, if you are doing Krishna bhajan, everything done, nothing left in your life, you see. And whenever you look any jivatma, whenever you look anywhere, any jivatma, you should think this way, that inside this creature, Paramatma is there. Paramatma, Supreme Lord is there. My Guru Padmo, somewhere he gone, someday he went, and you see some, you know, mosquito cutting all the night. Cutting here. And some devotees, oh, mosquito cutting. What to do? Let him take. He is not ready to beat him. So merciful. And also you can find it, you know, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one Kushti Brahman. One Brahman developing Kushtaruk, leprosy, full of, you know, insect, you know, full of, you know. When one insect going out of rolling down of his body, He is putting, hey, where to go? You cannot get fruit. Here is nice, plus you can get put here. You take, here is a blood and pale place, everything you can do. You are relaxed, you can feel relaxed here. This way, those who are Vaishnavas, they are, you know, all merciful, you see, all the time. They never take any revenge against anybody. They are always thinking positive way. Dayaya sarva bhutesu santushta jeno kenova sarvendriyo upo santva cha tushvanti asu janardana. They can satisfy Janardana very easily. Those who look around and see this jivatma, jivatma, all jivatma in relation to Krishna, they can see. Dayaya sarva bhuteshu. I can give one nice, you know, incident, not story. Sanskrit, you know, I wrote one article, 120 article in Sanskrit, one out of there. I heard it and then read, not I, you know. That's there. The Sanatan Gosai one day, going to Jamuna to take bath. While taking bath in Jamuna, he is saying Gayatri. And another devotee is also taking bath. Huh? Oh, okay. One, you know, brischik actually. That's, you know, crab. What do you say? It's cutting, poisonous. A scorpio. Yes. Scorpio. He fall down in water. Sunadin gula, oh Ram. He take the scorpio and put into branches. In the meantime, he cut. Some pain, poison. Very poisonous. Then again taking bath. Again the scorpio fall down. Again Sanatana putting into. Then another devotee. Oh Sadhu, Sanatanji, what you are doing? Again and again he is biting you, but still you want to protect that, you know, wicked, you know, scorpion? Sanatana goes smiling. What to do? What I have, I want to do. What he has poison, he like to give me. I have mercy, I like to give. One day, at the bank of Jamuna, practical story. At the bank of Jamuna and Keshighat, some rich, Sheth, you know, Sheth, rich man, is coming from Delhi. He wanted to distribute some blanket among devotees. And now he is sitting in Keshighat, and he has his one servant also helping him, knife. And they are all distributing, you know, blanket. One by, and those sadhu, they are in queue. Taking one blanket and going away. Taking one blanket, going away. But one sadhu is very wicked. He is not at all sadhu. He, with one blanket, is going and keep, change his dress, again coming. To take in queue. To get another blanket. But the set is very clever. Hey! You took blanket? No. Naib, he took blanket. Yes, I think so, but dress is not same. You took blanket. I cannot give you. No, I didn't take. I cannot give blanket to you. You took already. I remember. Then they said not going to give anything. No blanket, nothing, no pranami. Then he is going there in a rock. Rock means in a nice place and sitting. And speaking all rubbish. You are idiot, you are rascal, this, that. And some devotee is speaking, Naibji, actually, he is speaking all rubbish to you. Say, gali dichi apnake. He is speaking all rubbish to you. Then that Sheth become very happy and speaking, I have blanket, so I am giving blanket. He has his, his heart is so bad, so he is speaking all rubbish to me. His heart is full of rubbish, it's the go down of garbage. His heart is go down of all rubbish thing. So he is speaking all rubbish. If he has, what you have, you are going to give. So I have blanket, I am giving blanket. So you see, this way, Sanatana Gosai is speaking what to do. So I want to save this in scorpion. It likes to beat me repeatedly. What to do? He is doing his own duty. I am doing his own duty. In childhood, we all read, all Bengali people, I mean those Uriya also maybe, and Assamese, they are also reading this. Vidyasago, small book. Vidyasago. He write one nice Vyakaram, it's Vidyasago, Ocean of Sagar. But material ocean of Sagar, material Vidya. He wrote one thing, we are bound to read in childhood. Tumi adham boli ami uttam hoibo na keno. If you are a fallen soul, then it is not the reason for that I am going to be bad. I can become good. You are fallen, that doesn't mean I will have to become fallen. I am not going to fall down. Come down. This way actually we are going to finish this, you know, chapter, actually fourth canto. Very nice. And now we want to step into this, you know, fifth canto. From tomorrow I can discuss in detail about fifth canto, but today I like to touch this point. Srimad Bhagavad Ji, Mahapuran ki jai. Fifth canto, Pratham Adhyaya, first Adhyaya. You can remember, I was discussing about that, you know, Priyabrato and Uttanpad. Son of whom? Manu. Can you remember? Very fickle minded. Manu. Son of Manu is Uttanpad, and you see, Priyabrato Uttanpad. I told you already, Priyabrato is very conscious soul. He don't want to take charge of, you know, this in material world. He don't want to become king. So he leave this material world and going to forest to do bhajan by the advice of Naraji. In Gandhamadam Parvat, he is doing nice bhajan there, in a cave. And also I told in details about that, you know, Uttanpad, you know, from Uttanpad, Dhruva Maharaj came, these, that, all in details. Now we want to discuss about the, you know, Priyabrata destiny. And son, how? His family, you know, members. How? Now in the meantime, Parikshit Maharaj putting question in front of Sukhdev Goswami now at present. That's an incident spoken by Sutadev Goswami in front of Sanukadi Rishi. Now Maitri Muni is speaking to Vidurji. This way you will have to calculate. Sri Raju Vacho, Parikshit Maharaj now speaking in front of Gurudev. Oh Gurudev, Priyabrato Bhagavato Atma Ramaha Katham Mune Grihe Aramataha Janmulo Karma Bandaha Parabhavaha. Yes, you should read very nice way. Sri Raju Vacho, Priyabrato Bhagavato Atma Ramaha Katham Mune Grihe Aramato Janmulaho Karma Bandho Parabhavaha. Priyabrato, we heard Priyabrato Mahabhagavat, very excellent Atma Ram. Priyabrato Bhagavato Atma Ramaha Katham Mune Grihe Aramataha. We heard is Atma Ram. How it was possible for Priyabrata to come into this family life and lead family life? How? It's very excellent thing. Raja Parikshit Maharaj asking in front of Sukhdev Goswami, Priyabrato Bhagavato Atma Ramaho Katham Mune Grihe Aramato Janamulaho Karma Bandho Parabhava. Because this family life, material life is very dangerous. In each and every step, you can become defeated. Parabhava. Tavad vayam dobino dehu suhit nivityam tavas priha parabhavu vipulas chalobaha javan neta angri javan note angri mavayam prabhinite lokaha. Until and unless you take shelter of Supreme Lord, you are going to be defeated each and every step. You are Brahmin? You are greedy. Some place you are going there, somebody insulting you. You are so greedy, you are Brahmin? Ha! Useless. You are defeated. You see? In family life, you are defeated by wife each and every time. Why say, I don't know, you have to bring this dress for me. I like this dress. Well, you will have to wait at least 7 weeks. No! I saw it tomorrow, yesterday. If I are late, then the shopman can sell this. I need it now. This way, you are put it into pressure. This way, always you are put it into beer. You are defeated. You are defeated each and every time. So, Priyabrata, so the question is what? What question? Parikshit Maharaj asking, whereas we heard that this Param, actually Atmaram, then how it was possible for Priyabrata to come back again in family life and lead family life? Because each and every step here in this family life, the question of defeat coming. And another point is that no nunam mukta sanyanam tadrishanam dijarsava griheshu ovinivesho ayam pungsham bhavitumarhati. And such gigantic personality, super personality like Priyabhata, we cannot expect that kind of attraction so that he can come back and lead family life. No nunam mukta sanyanam. Why is Mukta Sangha? Why Priyabhata is free personality? He is not materially bonded soul, not bonded soul. Though Priyabhata entering into family life, be sure, he is not bonded soul. Janak Maharaj leading family life, but he is giving advice to all Rishi Muni. Janak, Rajarshi, so excellent. Janak Rishi wanted to test Sukhdev Goswami to see whether he is fit to take this Bhagavat Rasa or not. Vyasadeva Goswami, in front of Vyasadeva Goswami, Sukhdev came. Sukhdev wanted to hear more and more about Bhagavat Rasa. Vyasadeva Goswami thinking, if I start speaking Bhagavatam, then people can say, oh, he is a very personality. He is your son, that's why you are going to. So I want to get some certificate from a, I want to get one certificate from a certified personality. I want to get a certificate from a certified personality like Janak Maharaj, so that nobody can speak or rubbish against me. So better I can send my son to Janak Raj. He can test and find out the result, that he is just fit. Do you find him fit so that I can get Bhagavad Rasa? Hey, you go to Janak Maharaj. Janak Maharaj for 3 days testing Sukhdev Goswami. For 3 days, is there in Puran. For 3 days testing Sukhdev Goswami very heavily, but cannot do anything. He is not defeated. Then Janakji Maharaj speaking, I bless. You are the fittest personality to accept this Bhagavad Rasa. I approve, give certificate. This way, Sukadev Goswami getting this Bhagavad Rasa. And from Sukadev, Sukho Mukhad Amrita Dava Sangyutam. We are getting this nectar this way. So, Priyabrato Bhagavato Atmarama Katham Mune. Grihe aramato janmulah karma bandho parabhavah nanunam mukta sanganam tadrishinam didarsavah griheshu avineveshu ayam pungsham bhavitumarhati. We can never expect any kind of attraction inside the heart of that Priyabhata. Is actually he got good association, satsanga, sangha. Good association of Naraji Maharaj. So it's not possible. And Parikshit Maharaj, the same time speaking, Mahatam khalu viprasher uttam sloko padayo chayan nibritta chityanam na kutumbya sprihamati. Mahatam khalu viprasher uttam sloko padayo. Hey, Sukhdev, Gurudev, Mahatam khalu viprasher uttam sloko padayo. Chayan nibritta chityanam na kutumbya sprihamati. Those who are already attracted unto the lotus feet of Krishna, they cannot feel any attraction to maintain their family life. It's my wife, children. No. Mahatam khalu viprase. Mahatam khalu. Khalu manishchita mepa. Mahatam khalu viprase uttama sloka padayo. Chayan nibritta jityanam na kutumbya sprihamati. And you see, Uttam Sloka Bhagavan, his lotus feet is like umbrella. You know? He's doing well, soothing feeling. Very nice. It is not possible for him to grow interest in family life. I mean, is my son, daughter, you know, wife, this way. No kutumbe sprihamati. As Sangsoya, I am expressing doubt. So could you cut this kind of, you know, doubt? I like to get answer from you. Sangsoyo ayam mahano brahman dara garo sutadishu saktasajat siddhir abhut krishne cha mati rachita. I am expressing doubt. How is that possible? You know, he is staying in family life, leading family life, ruling the whole world. And his attraction here and there, we see. But how he got Siddhi, how so great attraction to the lotus feet of Krishna, how was that possible? Now, Sukhdev Goswami giving answer is, well, see. Sukhdev Goswami is giving answer, O Rajan. Badam uktam. Badam mean? Sanskrit is am mane okay. Badam okay. Duto. Yes. Okay. Om. Om mane hoche? Raji hoa. Okay. But here actually badam. Thik aje tumi ja bolle, it's okay. Badam uktam. You are putting nice question. Badam uktam bhagavatu. Uttama sloko sasimat charanaravinda makaranda rasu avishito chetaso bhagavatu paramahansa daito katham kinchit antarayo vihitam swam sivatamam padabhimna paina hinnanti. One life, you have to control your, you know, breathing. You cannot control, you can break. So power you need inside, so you can speak. At a time in one breath you will have to speak whole sloka, see, big sloka. So this way, Sukadeva Goswami is speaking, Badam is okay, Rajan. You are putting nice question, Badam Uktam. Bhagavata Ustama Srokusho Simat Charanaravinda Makaranda Rasu Abhishita Chetaso Bhagavata Paramahansa Daito Kathayam Kinchit Antaraya Vihitam Swam Sivatamam Padabhimna Prayena Hinvanti. Those who are getting, Rajan, those who are getting the, you know, nectar, I mean the honey, from the lotus feet of their Supreme Lord. Simat charanaravinda makaranda raso abheshat chetasa. His heart is full of nectarian feeling. So maybe externally you can see he is stepping into family life, but still it is not at all harmful for him. Be careful, Rajan. It is not at all harmful for him. You see, it is not at all harmful for him. So tomorrow we can discuss all in details about the destiny of Priyavrata Maharaj, you know. So, you see, enjoying, actually, tomorrow we can speak in details. Yatha tararamola nisecha nena tippanti taskanda bhujo pusa prano paharascha yathendriyanam tataiva sarva araharanam uchyate ajya Vancha kalpataru sekya basindi bhavacha vatitanam pamanibhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha.